Vâng, vâng ạ. Pardon? Just no, yeah. Nobody demanded today. Okay, anyway, just we have just started with the customizing. So for the sake of recording, let me start it. So this is the sales document category. This is the sales. Not this one, okay. So this document category says whether this is a sales order or inquiry or quotation. So ours is a sales order, so we have chosen the C. And this is the number range assignment. So when you assign 01, the system takes what is the number range that is associated with this 01 and takes the number when you are saving the sales order. This item number increment is what we just saw now. So when you create a sales order, how the system numbers the each item, so whether it is 10, 20 or 30, or you can, if you change the range here, the system will take it accordingly. For example, if you make it as some odd number like 9, then it is a 9, 18, 27, 36. Okay. Then the sub-item increment. The sub-item increment is used for, the sub-item increment is normally used for your, what do you call it? Your free item or bill of materials, whatever could be. So why, a small question, like why we maintain the item number as 10 and sub-item increment as 1? Because here we are going to use the bill of material concept, which means there will be a main item which will be having many sub-items. Okay. So the sub-items, so for example, let me say my main item is a computer. My sub items are, what are the items in desktop can contain? A monitor, a CPU, a keyboard, a mouse, a UPS, uninterrupted power supply, and your modem. So let me say there are 5 items. If I don't maintain the sub item increment, what happens? My computer will be item number 10, my monitor will be item number 20, my UPS will be item number 30. So you won't be able to differentiate whether it is a main item or part of some items. So to differentiate that only, you had given the main item as 10 and sub-item increment as number 1. Then this is our reference mandatory. If you had made it as a mandatory reference, the system will always look for a preceding document based on which you have to create the sales order. For example, if you had entered it as B, you must have a quotation before creating a sales order. Without entering the quotation number in your reference, you won't be able to create a sales order. So that is why by default we normally leave the sales order reference as, mandatory reference as blank. Then is the check division. Do you remember, like if you go to the sales order, okay, so let me, okay, right now we are in this. Whenever you make change, make sure you exit from that particular screen. Because till you do that, the system won't refresh the database and your changes won't be reflected. So I had come out from there, I had come out from here also. Can you see the system has taken a sales area of 1000 is my sales organization, 10 is my distribution channel and 00 is my division. But I enter an article, I go to the article details. I can see the article having some other division. Okay, So the basic reason is because even though like you have created a sales area, if you want to include the products of other division also in the same sales order, then you have to make this customizing of enable divisions. Check division. You have to disable the sales order checking the division. If you don't do this, the system will check for your item division also, and it will say the header division and item division are different. So that is why we won't be able to create the sales order. But if you enable this, what the problem is, like, let me say a customer gives me a purchase order for 5 items, out of which 3 belong to division 01 and 1 for division 02, then 1 for division 03. So in such cases I have to go for 3 different sales orders if I make the system to check the divisions, which is for sales area 1010 01. Okay, for that I have to make the first 3 items, then I have to go for another sales order 1010 02, enter the second item, this is my second sales order, and 1010 03, this is my third sales order. Not only it makes me to create 3 sales orders, I have to maintain the customer master, that is the sales area data, for all these 3 different sales area, which is going to result in manifold increase in your data maintenance. So it is not advisable to enable the check division at the item level in your sales order. But why this functionality is provided? Because you might want to restrict sales of particular goods to the particular customer or particular distribution channel or something. So for enabling the restriction, which means like you might want to sell that particular goods only through particular sales area, which means when you are creating a sales order, the system will check the header division as well as the item division, and only when it is same, the system will allow you to create the sales order. So that is the functionality for this. Then you have to check the credit limit, and what does this D stands for, that you will see at the credit management. As of now, all you can see is the system can recheck the credit limit. We have seen that the system takes the data from customer material info record as priority. If you don't enable this read info record, then the system will not read the CMIR. Instead, it takes the data only from your customer master and material master. Then this is the check purchase order number. So right now when I am creating the sales order, what I did normally, I entered the functionality which you are doing as a PO number, then sales order customizing or something. But in real time, it will be some numbers that is given by your customer's PO number. Okay. So if you enable the check purchase order number, if somebody, for example, like most of the cases it comes in sacks and it will be lying in the sacks machine. Before you had taken it, somebody else, sometimes you automatically receive 2 copies by mistake. Okay. So you had taken the first copy and you had made the sales order using that purchase order reference. And if somebody mistakenly takes the second copy and try to make a sales order using the same purchase order number, and if you have enabled the functionality here, then the system will say your purchase order number is already existing or it has already been used. So are you trying to duplicate? So then make this enter PO number. So what happens is, like, if I don't enter the PO number also, the system will just give me a warning, that's it. Now it is not giving the warning also, since I had entered the article. Okay. The system will just give me a warning, and it can allow me to save the sales order even without entering the purchase order number. But if I enter this purchase order number, then the system will say you have until unless you have you enter the purchase order number, you won't be able to save the document. Okay. So then you have the screen sequence group. Screen sequence group is like is basically the code related with the code. I mean, what happens the moment you save the sales order, where does the system where does the system go? Which means where does what is available in your screen the moment you save the sales order? It will be the same sales order making you to enter the next set of data. For example, okay, as of now let me save this sales order. You go to condition. Here 00 custom major 395. Okay, this is my sales order screen. If I save this, either it can go to ECS screen or it can go to my previous screen where I can enter the order type and come in again. Else I can make the system to be here itself so that I can enter further orders, create sales orders. I can create further. See, the system just stands there. No need of going to the previous screens. Okay. So, this screen sequence is controlled by this. Okay. So, how this is being done? This is basically a coding thing and we don't have any control over this. So, as of now, you just enter AO. So this is the display range. Display range is like we just now we had seen we have main items, we have sub items. Okay. So when you create a sales order, what are the things the system must display? Both main items or sub items, then you choose the UL. If you want to maintain display only the main items, then you choose this UHCU. Okay. If you want to maintain display only the selected items, then you use the UMAR. So it's always better to leave it as UAL, which means your main item as well as sub items can be displayed in the same screen. Then is the function code for overview screen. Which overview screen you have to go? For example, I am entering the sales document type OR and pressing enter. The system takes me to the sales overview screen. But I feel like this is taking half of my screen, taking lot of my real estate, okay, and I am able to, as this is a high resolution monitor, okay, you are seeing so many lines here, but in case of low resolution monitor like 1024 pixels or 800 pixels, then this particular part itself will take lot of spaces. So you will be left with only one or two lines in the screen to enter your articles. So you don't want to do that. You want to switch to the item overview screen the moment you enter the OR. The previous screen you enter OR and press enter. If you want the system to take you to the item overview screen directly, that functionality is controlled here. Okay. If I enter UER2, the moment I press OR and click the enter button, it will take me to the items overview screen, not the general overview screen. Okay. So this is the function code for overview screen. This is what the messages I have been talking to you about, the open outline agreements and the open contract quotation messages. It checks for the item level and it checks for the header level, which means if you enable at the header level, the moment you enter the cell, customer number, the sold to party, and the enter the purchase number, it will say, even before you enter the article number, the system will say, for this customer, you have open quotations. Okay, sometimes it will be useful, sometimes it will be jarring, because you might have entered so many quotations for the same customer, but this sales order is not with reference to any quotation given previously. So to avoid that only we normally give it to the item level. You have so many actions here after. For example, if the header and item are unique, then the system can automatically copy the existing quotation. This means like if there is only one quotation for that customer and you are going to, you enter the customer number in your sales order and press enter, if you have chosen this option 3, that is C, the system automatically copies the value from your quotation, even you don't give any reference explicitly. If you choose D, if you enter that particular item, so based on that previous quotation, it takes the value. And if you enter the E and F, the system will give me a list of quotations, and from that quotation only, you can choose which one to go. So this is very useful in terms of contracts basically. So this outline quotation messages and outline agreement messages are done here. Okay. Then you will see. Okay. The moment you create, you have created a sales order and you have created a delivery. Till now you must not have noticed what is your delivery type. Do one thing, open one of your existing delivery and you go to the header, administrative data, you can see what the delivery type is. How does the system know for this sales order, this must be my delivery type? So that is configured by your delivery type entered here. So what delivery type you enter here, the system creates a delivery of this kind when you are creating a subsequent delivery. This function code cannot be set. Then is your billing. So we have similarly, once you have created a delivery and you are going for billing, the system creates a billing of certain type. Till now we have been seeing F2. Why F2, why not F3 or why not F1? The answer lies here. You had told the system like for this sales order, my billing type is going to be F2. Since you had defined F2 here, when you are creating a delivery at a later time, when you are creating a billing at a later time, the system creates a billing with type F2. Okay. The payment guarantee is what we can see later. And how that 7 days come? So VA01, when you go to VA01, how did the system create the date 4? Why not 3 or why not 2 or why not today? And when I create a cash sale, why it creates for today's date? So that lead time is proposed here. Okay. And if you enter a proposed delivery date and give a lead time, the system will add this number of days from today and automatically populate in the required delivery date. If you don't click a proposed delivery date, the system will still leave that place the place of required delivery date as blank, but it is a mandatory field. Without entering that field, you cannot proceed further. So that is the case. And we will see these contract details when we come to the contract. Okay. So as of now, since we are creating the delivery billing and we have seen the number ranges, so as of now we will concentrate only on these activities. Okay. So let us go and see the another document type so that we can understand how it differs. Okay. So let us choose the sales cash sales document. For my cash sale, the external number range is different, there it was 02, okay, there is no sub-item increment here, and the number range is the same, okay. They didn't allow you to read the info record, because if the system reads the info record, then it takes the trans from the info record, and it goes for your availability check and other thing based on that. But in this case, the customer walks into the delivery plant directly and takes it up. So, this read info record is disabled. And since he is paying the money immediately, there is no credit check. So, check credit limit and check credit group are disabled. Okay. And the rest of the things are the same. Okay. And here you can see there is an immediate delivery. Which means only because of this setting, the system creates a delivery immediately when you create a cash sale. And the delivery type is also different. There it was LF, but here it is BV. Okay. And the shipping conditions is normally looked at from the sales order type first. If it is not found here, then it will be taken from the customer master. Why? Because for the same customer, I can create a normal delivery, but for the same customer, if I use the cash sale type, the system says it is a immediately deliverable condition. So that is why the shipping condition is taken from the delivery, ordering document first. If not found in the ordering document type, then it will be taken from the customer master. For OR, we didn't see any shipping conditions because it was blank. But for delivery, cash sale, you have to make sure that the delivery is created immediately. So that is why here we have entered the shipping conditions. Similarly, we have maintained the billing type. For our normal sales, the billing type is F2. For here it is BV because it is a cash sales thing. And here the system proposed the delivery date, but it didn't give any lead time. Instead, it gave the today's date itself. So that is why when you create a cash sale, the system automatically takes today's date. Then there is no contract return data because cash sale is not normally related to any contract. So that is why you don't have any this thing, and there is no availability check also configured here. I do one thing, you go through some of the other document types. You can note it down. You can see RO and you can see FDV. Yeah, you can use the other document, check the other document type, RO, that is rush order, FD, that is delivery free of charge, what is here in the system. You can create new entry. While creating new entry, do one thing, you select any one of that and choose the copy as. Why? Because if you don't, then document types must always be assigned to a sales area. Only when it is assigned to a sales area, you will be able to create a sales order. Let me show in the screen, assign sales area to document type. What are things we created? Assign document type to printed for sales area. What is the sales area? Normally we are seeing 1000, 1000. For 1000, 1000. Okay, for this combination you can see, okay, so many things are there. For this combination you had assigned the GAOR. Okay, that is why you are able to create a sales order. If you haven't assigned this sales order to this sales area, you won't be able to create a document type. Not only this thing, there are so many things. How the document is flowing from one document to other document, that is because of something called as copy control. If you create a new document type by pressing the new entry, then you have to manually assign this to the sales area, then you have to manually create the copy control for the document to subsequent document type. There are so many things available, you have to do. But if you copy existing document and copy from the existing one and rename it to your needed one, then the system automatically carries out or copies the existing assignment. For example, if you create OR and change it as ZAOR, then where and all OR is assigned to, this ZAOR will also be automatically assigned. Similarly, there will be a copy control between your order and delivery, OR and LF. So if you create ZAOR, OR from ZA, if you copy OR and rename it to ZAOR, the system will maintain the copy controls of OR to LF also. Okay, which means ZAOR can be copied into LF. So that is why initially when you are creating, don't create anything by putting new entries. Instead, you choose the existing one. For example, let me say OR, I select that, I go and I create copy as. Okay, here I can enter something here. Custom. Okay. It will ask for whether the for copy control is also relevant for copy control. May mark it as yes, so that it will copy all these controls. So then I can go into this and I can make all my changes. I don't want the number range. I want my number range 45 because that is what I have created, and I want the system to increment the numbers in 7, 14, 21. And the subitems must be increased by 2. I want a mandatory reference from quotation, which means without quotation I cannot enter the sales order. Okay, I don't want to have credit limit. So I can go and I can make all the changes. I want the system to go to item over the screen the moment I press enter. Okay, I want to display only the main items UHAU. So these are how I copy and then I can make the setting. Okay. So if you have time, you can copy an existing sales order. I don't want to change it, make it change. Okay. If you want, you can use the existing sales. I mean, copy an existing sales order. Make all your customizations. Changes are customizations, and then go to VA01. Instead of OR, enter your newly created order type and then you will be able to proceed. Okay. While creating, always remember the naming convention must start with Z. Okay. And in the description, make sure that you enter your name so that you can not only easily identify, somebody will also know like, okay, this has been customized by somebody, so let us not mess with that. Okay. That's how. Yeah. Number and is in the same screen, you can see the third one. Okay. Okay. Practice. We will catch up tomorrow. Bye. Material I will send, but it won't be this much exhaustive. Okay, I will send that. Okay, I will send it. Whatever I have, I will send it.